For this final stretch of our tour of Westwood Village Memorial Park, we'll be visiting the central lawn of the cemetery. This lawn is little more than an acre, so due to space limitations, many of the plots here are smaller cremation graves. Just northwest, we find actress Natalie Wood. She won hearts the world over when she was just 9 years old for her role in Miracle on 34th Street. A successful acting career followed, transitioning from popular child star to ingenue, when at 16 she starred opposite James Dean in Rebel Without a Cause, a role which earned her an Academy Award nomination. One of her best known roles is as Maria in the musical West Side Story.
Tonight, tonight, it all began tonight. I saw you and the world went down. What you are, what you do, what you say.
The death of Natalie Wood in 1981, at the age of 43, is one of Hollywood's lingering mysteries. She was on a holiday boat trip off Catalina Island with her husband, Robert Wagner, and co-star Christopher Walken. Late on the night of November 28th, she somehow ended up in the water while trying to board a dinghy alone. Her body was found the next morning a mile away from the boat, the small dinghy found on a nearby beach. The official cause is listed as drowning and other undetermined factors. Finally, we head west to find one of Hollywood's legendary producers and studio kingpins, Darrell F. Zanuck. He is the man behind 20th Century Pictures, the most successful independent film studio in the 1930s. In 1935, Zanuck merged 20th Century with Fox Studios, creating one of Hollywood's greatest production companies, 20th Century Fox. Notable films made under his tenure include Laura, The Grapes of Wrath, and All About Eve, which earned him an Oscar. He wasn't afraid to tackle controversial issues such as racism, anti-Semitism, and environmentalism long before such themes were fashionable. The music from his film, The Longest Day, played at his funeral.